नमस्ते, सो नाउ लेट अस कवर आउट मेनली ऑर्डर टू रूल टू. आई विल जस्ट गिव यू एन इंट्रो टू इट सो दैट यू कैन कीप इट इन माइंड व्हाइल राइटिंग एन आंसर बिकॉज इवेंचुअली दैट इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू फेच यू मार्क्स. फर्स्ट लेट अस रिवाइज. व्हाट आर फोर इंग्रेडिएंट्स ऑफ अ सूट आर पार्टीज, कॉज ऑफ एक्शन. आई वोंट राइट द फुल थिंग, आई जस्ट राइट कॉज ऑफ एक्शन. सब्जेक्ट मैटर, राइट. अच्छा, थोड़ा पेन चेंज करना पड़ेगा बिकॉज दिस इज अ न्यू बोर्ड. गिव मी वन सेकंड. सब्जेक्ट मैटर एंड व्हाट इज द लास्ट वन. साथ साथ दिस हैज टू बी ऑन योर टिप्स. ऑलराइट, सो रिलीफ क्लेम्ड. ऑलराइट, याद करने का तरीका पीसीएस जे. अब जे से तो नहीं है तो फिर रिलीफ क्लेम्ड याद करना पड़ेगा. ऑलराइट, पीसीएस that primarily that is what you will be applying for. No, every time you write an answer, try to write this has to go. So this has to be on your fingertips whether you remember anything else or not. All right, so now we come to order 2 mainly, that is frame of suit. Some persons as plaintiffs having a cause of actions, other as defendants. So you will need, like, what is the first primary requirement in a suit? You will need some people as plaintiffs and some folks as defendants. Now, it can be one plaintiff versus one defendant, several plaintiffs versus several defendants, one plaintiff versus several defendants, multiple plaintiff versus the same defendant. Alag alag variation and everything mostly is allowed, except of course subject to some conditions. And what exactly will the examiner check you on if a question pops up from this topic is whether you know those conditions or not. It is as simple as that. So we go to order 2, frame of suit. So now naya order paida hua hai hamare liye, right? Up till now order 6 kya tha, abhi main revise karata hu. As in revision ki main ek sheet banaunga, aapko from memory wo kaam karna hai. Order 2, frame of suit. Every suit shall as far as practicable be framed so as to afford ground for final decision upon the subjects in dispute, and so of course this is a compulsory condition, and to prevent further litigation concerning them. Tell me, do you see the pre-ka question? Open your bare act of course to order 2. Do you see the pre-ka question? This entire sentence can be given to you. Every suit shall so far as practically framed so as to, option A, to afford ground for final decision. Yeah, ye pura bhi na likhe final decision to samajh lijiyega ki kya chah raha hai aapse, and to prevent further litigation. The main object of order 2, mainly, broadly speaking, not talking about any specific rule, is to prevent you to come to court again and again and again. Why so? Because bheed bahut zyada hai, we folks are just too many, judge saab kam hai, aur agar aap log baar baar uth ke aate rahenge to kaam kaise chalega? The entire judicial system is going to collapse. Yaad aa raha article 20 clause 2, double jeopardy, something on those lines. So this is the build up to res judicata, by the way. We understand this, and then next we go to res judicata because that is the perhaps the most important topic. To usme res judicata pooch rahe hai, differentiate between res judicata and estoppel, differentiate res judicata res sub judice. So section 10 section 11 ke bare mein baat karenge iske baad. However, lekin res judicata mein aisa hoga nahi ki aap order 2 aur rule 2 nahi likhenge. Rule 2 वगैरह क्या है भी देखते हैं. डू यू सी प्री का क्वेश्चन? ऑलराइट, नाउ सूट टू इंक्लूड द होल क्लेम. एवरी सूट शैल इंक्लूड द होल ऑफ द क्लेम विच द प्लेंटिफ इज एंटाइटल्ड टू मेक. वन सेकेंड, आई एडिट माई पेन अगेन क्योंकि अब मुझे चाहिए मार्कर और थोड़े से कम साइज का चाहिए. ठीक है जी. टू मेक इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ द कॉज ऑफ एक्शन, but a plaintiff may relinquish and portion of his claim in order to bring the suit within the jurisdiction of any court. Meaning, let us say that your property value is 75 lakh, and let us say the district court ki pecuniary jurisdiction ends at 50 lakhs, and aapne us property value pe suit karna, and let us say that you want to, you know, you want to claim 75 lakhs out of that property. Can you relinquish a part of your claim to bring the suit within the jurisdiction? You tell me from common sense, forget the Bayer Act. The moment you relinquish such part of the claim, will you be allowed later on to sue for it? Think about the logic of you coming again and again and again to the court. नहीं allow करेंगे, कहीं ना कहीं पक्का लिख देंगे लोग. Right. So the plaintiff for sure is allowed to relinquish a portion of his claim in order to bring the suit within the jurisdiction of the court. Let us say that you have to recover 50 lakh rupees from someone, and the pecuniary jurisdiction of the court is only 45 lakhs. And the court in which you want the court to hear it for your own convenience to keep the litigation costs, etc. down, let go of that 5 lakh rupees. It is absolutely allowed. Now, this is different from grossly, so the keyword is grossly undervaluing the suit. Ki bhaiya, ye to bahut zyada hi chhod ke, wo aap badmashi kar rahe hain, so you are going for forum shopping. Wo aisi cheez court nahi allow karega. But these things, these are what is called as minor inconveniences of life. Sure enough, you can do as per order 2, rule 2. Achha, to order 2 ho gaya, frame of suit. Order 6 kya tha? Pleadings generally. Order 7 kya tha? Plaint. Order 8 kya tha? Written statement, set off and counterclaim. Even though you're watching this in a pre-recorded format, I'm generally not on your head to see whether you're saying this, but you have to speak it out aloud with me. Right. Order 21, execution rules 1 to 106. Order 5 mein kitne rule? Rules 1 to rule 30. Check it from your Bayer Act right now. Pause the lecture and check order 5 ke andar kitna kaam hai. I'll give you a sheet in the next screen. Okay. Now, kehta relinquishment of part of claim, where a plaintiff omits to sue in respect of or intentionally relinquishes any portion of his claim, he shall not not afterwards sue in respect of the portion so omitted or relinquished. So it is up to the plaintiff ki bhaiya soch le. Is time pe agar tune ye cheez chhodi to bring it under the jurisdiction of any court, we will not allow it later. Do you understand this? That is what order 2, rule 2, sub rule 2 says. This is extremely important. So order 2, rule 2, sub rule 2. Alright. Omission to sue for one of several reliefs. A person to entitled to more than one relief in respect of the same cause of action may sue for all or any of such. Hang on for 1 second. I'll explain this to you with examples. Those examples you have to write in your answers. See, primarily speaking, I can teach you as much theory as you possibly can want to learn from me. However, my main aim is to get you into the judicial services, is to get you a selection. So that happens primarily on the basis of mains, because pre is just a screening exam. So whatever I'm teaching you, it is highly selected, filtered out stuff from the point of view of mains, the examples that you have to quote. So whenever you get an opportunity, of course they are not going to ask these things like very, very straightforward, in a very straightforward manner, ki word to word jo maine padhaya wo aa jayega. No. The concept you will have to repeat, because this, at the end of the day, an exam such as DJS specifically is a concept based exam. You cannot, mainly it is a concept based exam. So there are questions which are purely Ratta based. Article 21A relates to what, for example, the general legal knowledge ka paper, DPSPs or what, for example. Now that is all Ratta based, just one liner MCQ. Technically speaking, they're MCQs only. The main crux of the papers, that is civil law 1, civil law 2, is concept based. So concept ke andar, yahan se concept samajh ke, you will have to sit down and write answers as many times as you possibly can. That is the only way to crack this. There is no other way. No other way exists for this exam. Alright, now we come here. Write this down from memory. So, ऐसे एक शीट बना लीजिए, ऑर्डर 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, रूल्स 1 टू 30, ऑफ कोर्स एज आई टोल्ड यू, 6, 7, 8 शुड नाउ बी ऑन योर टंग. ऑर्डर 21 रूल 1 टू 106, सेक्शन 99 में क्या था, सेक्शन 120 में ऐसे कौन से तीन सेक्शंस थे विच डू नॉट अप्लाई टू द हाई कोर्ट इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ इट्स ओरिजिनल ज्यूरिसडिक्शन, वर दे 16, 17, 20, सेक्शन 15 में कौन सा कोर्ट ऑफ विच ग्रेड वॉज टू ट्राई द the court. And what was section 21 all about? Objection to be taken at the earliest possible instance. Otherwise, at the appellate level or the revisional level, we will not allow an objection. Objection relating to what? Territorial jurisdiction, subject matter jurisdiction, or pecuniary jurisdiction? Pause the lecture here. Write this down on your left hand side. Open your bare act. अगर अभी ये याद नहीं आ रहे तो कोई बात नहीं. Order 1 में क्या दे रखा है, 2 में क्या दे रखा है, 3 में क्या दे रखा है. Write this down. Only the main topic. So order 1 क्या है? Parties to suit. 2 क्या है? Frame of suit. जैसा कि अभी हमने देखा, right? Frame of suit. देखते हैं. I just want you to write from memory ये वाले सारे. Order 21 rules 1 to 106. There is no way on the planet that you will end up remembering word to word rule 1 to rule 30 के अंदर each and every rule के अंदर क्या क्या दे रखा है. करना भी नहीं है. Bare act सामने पड़ी हुई है भाई. करना भी नहीं. Do not even try to attempt वो LLB entrance style वाला काम नहीं चलता यहाँ पे. Judiciary is a different ball game altogether. So 6, 7, 8 and यहाँ पे 21 के अंदर क्या था. अच्छा, और 37 section 67 of the TPA. Whatever we have learned till now, you will make a sheet. 99, 120, 15 and 21, you'll make a sheet. You will write the titles of these orders. अच्छा, आप कहेंगे अभी वो 3, 4 तो करा नहीं, तो कोई बात नहीं ना, भी करेंगे. However, उनका नाम तो Bare Act से निकाल के आप खुद लिख लेंगे. जब मैं आऊँगा तो मैं दोबारा शीट बनाते चलूँगा और मैं आपकी जान खानी छोड़ूंगा नहीं. आई विल ट्राई टू रिपीट दिस एज मैनी टाइम्स बिकॉज दिस विल हेल्प यू इन प्री एंड दिस विल सेव यू टाइम इन मेन्स. मेन में लोगों को लगता है Bare Act सामने बड़ी कर ही लेंगे. भाई साहब, टाइम लिमिट भी तो है क्या? पूरा दिन थोड़े ना है, वहाँ 3 घंटे हैं. अगर मेमोरी में ही नहीं है क्या? Bare Act छान छान के उसके वहाँ से आप जॉट डाउन करेंगे? टाइम कहाँ है आपके पास? दिस इज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे अ कॉम्पिटिशन एंड योर कॉम्पिटिशन मोस्टली इज वर्किंग हार्डर देन वी आर. सो वी हैव टू वर्क एज हार्डर एंड मोर हार्डर देन देन दे आर. वील डू वेरी वेरी स्मार्ट वर्क टू क्लियर द एग्जाम. ऑलराइट, पॉज कर लीजिए लेक्चर और हर रोज़ होमवर्क, जब तक CPC ख़त्म नहीं हो रही, जब तक CPC पढ़ रहे हैं, और CPC पढ़ने के बाद भी रफ शीट निकाल के बार बार लगातार लिखते रहिए. और जब लगे कि यार ये तो मैं भूल गया 99 में क्या था, खोलिए Bare Act. उसी टाइम खोलना, उसी टाइम, वेदर यू आर ऑन एन इंस्टाग्राम रील और व्हाटएवर, पॉज दैट, थ्रो द फोन आउट ऑफ द विंडो, कैन डोंट डू दैट, बट इसको लिखना. लिख के ही काम होगा. जितनी बार लिखेंगे एग्जाम में, धक 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 धक, काम खत्म. ठीक है जी, आगे चलते हैं. नाउ ऑर्डर टू रूल टू, हमेशा व्हेनेवर यू यूजिंग ऑर्डर टू रूल टू, हमेशा ये लाइन लिखनी है. ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ ऑर्डर टू रूल टू इज टू प्रिवेंट प्लेंटिफ फ्रॉम ब्रिंगिंग मल्टीपल सूट्स ऑन द सेम कॉज ऑफ एक्शन. वी विल जस्ट गेट टू व्हाट दिस इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ एग्जांपल्स. नाउ व्हेनेवर यू मेंशनिंग ऑर्डर टू रूल टू, यू विल राइट द सिमिलर प्रोविजन फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज आर्टिकल 20 क्लॉज 2, दैट इज No defendant ought to be vexed twice for the same cause. यही है इसका ऑब्जेक्ट. और डबल जेपर्डी में भी यही है कि एक बार ही आदमी की पनिशमेंट हो गई. आर्टिकल 20 क्लॉज 2, अगर नहीं याद आ रहा पॉज कर लेना, आर्टिकल 20 पूरा रिवाइज करके आना. 20 क्लॉज 1 में क्या दे रखा है, 20 क्लॉज 2 में क्या दे रखा है, इन ये आपका 20 क्लॉज 3 में क्या दे रखा है, इनक्रिमिनेशन, राइट अगेंस्ट सेल्फ इनक्रिमिनेशन 20 क्लॉज 3, 20 क्लॉज 2 इज डबल जेपर्डी, 20 क्लॉज 1 इज वॉट, प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव लॉज. यही है ना, ex post facto laws technically in on the criminal side. याद कर लेना बार बार लगातार, जो उनसे मर्जी स्टेट का एग्जाम दीजिए आपकी इच्छा. ठीक है जी, ओके. सो स्प्लिटिंग द क्लेम इज नॉट अलाउड. नाउ ये तो होगी थ्योरी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एग्जाम्पल से इलस्ट्रेट करके आइएगा अपना हर आंसर. इसको बताइएगा कि बाबूजी दिल्ली हाईकोर्ट वाले भैया, मुझे आता है, मुझे ये पता है, ये कॉन्सेप्ट मुझे पता है, कानून तो तुमने मेरे को हाथ में पकड़ाया हुआ Bare Act. नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल, मुकुल्स वैन, इट कोलाइड्स विद नंदिनीज वैन. बड़ी दुखद बात है, बोथ आर स्टूडेंट्स, बोथ आर एक्सीलेंट स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ आर बैच. मुकुल्स वैन इज कोलाइडेड विद नंदिनीज वैन. पता नहीं मुकुल जी को क्या खुंदक आई कि मेरा कॉम्पिटिशन जा रहा है, अगर ये इसको सीट मिल गई तो इसकी तो पहले ही एक्सीडेंट कर देते हैं. फिर मुकुल जी बदमाश आदमी हो गए इस हिसाब से. तो हाउएवर, नाउ सी देयर, let us say that there are two effects of this collision. One is damage to Nandini's van and second is bodily injury to Nandini. Nandini ke koi haath pair wagera toot gaya ki us din ye pre de hi na paaye, right? Now Nandini can bring two different suits, one for damage to van and one for the bodily injury that has happened. Two different suits are allowed बिकॉज यू कैन से कि भाई कॉज ऑफ एक्शन दोनों में अलग अलग है. हाउएवर कैन शी लेट अस से विद इन बॉडीली इंजरी कैन शी ब्रिंग वन सूट फॉर बॉडी एंड लेग्स एंड वन सूट फॉर लेट अस से इंटरनल इंजरीज दैट हैव हैपेंड बट शी डजंट नो देम येट एंड लेटर ऑन शी सेज ये नया सूट डालना है जी मेरा तो यहाँ पे it broke my ribs also later on it broke my ribs it you know I never really knew at that moment of impact that it did to main pehle suit dal chuki thi ab ye wala do you think by common sense it should be allowed no even if later you find out internal injuries have taken no so technically speaking two broad suits different suits can be filed that is Nandini's van and bodily injury Nandini now think Can she club these two suits into one suit? Possibly can because it relates to the same transaction. The cause of action, even though multiple cause of actions are arising, but they're arising out of the same transaction. Alright. So, for example, in the illustration जो हमने पहले देखी थी कि वो जो builder का वो जो check back जो bounce हो गया था in your practical overview of the plaint, वहाँ पे cause of action है कि उसमें आप multiple suits नहीं डाल सकते. Because court ke paas utna time nahi hai. The court will not look at it again and again and again, you know. Aage chalte hain. So iska jo LLM ya UGC net mein jo classic case law that is Brunson versus Humphrey, wahi poochte hain. If you want to mention it in your answer, you can. But iske koi kahani mention nahi kar payenge. Achha, the order to plea is highly technical and must be taken specifically. Court usually doesn't take suo motu cognizance of it. However, usually ये academic बात है practically तो court देख ही लेता है कि क्या होता है क्या नहीं होता. Now example, let us say Nandini has a PG in which Mukul is staying. The yearly rent is ₹60,000, all right. So for year 2000 and year 2001 and year 2002, he says नहीं Nandini madam मैं तो गरीब आदमी हूँ मैं कहाँ से ही PG का आपका rent दे दूँगा मैं तो judiciary clear करके ही दिखाऊँगा उसके बाद कभी बात करूँगा. उसके बाद इन्होंने कहा judiciary clear कर भी ली और उसके बाद आई नहीं रेंट देने. वैसे ऐसे मुकुल ऐसा नहीं है व्यक्ति लेकिन कोई बात नहीं मान लेते हैं कि ऐसा कुछ हो गया. लेट अस से दैट नंदिनी ओनली सूज ओनली फॉर 2002 लेटर शी कांट सू फॉर 2000 एंड 2001 इट इज द ओनर्स इज ऑन द प्लेंटिफ क्या था ऑर्डर टू के अंदर जरा बैरेट खोल के रखना मैं भी आता हूँ वापस ऑर्डर टू के अंदर जरा देखूँ कहाँ पे है मेरा ऑर्डर टू स्क्रीन पे अच्छा पीछे था ये रहा कह रहे Every suit shall include the whole of the claim which the plaintiff is entitled to make in respect of the cause of action, but a plaintiff may relinquish in portion. ठीक है जी. Why can't she sue it later? As in why can't she go for it later? कि year 2000-2001 वाले रह गए थे. Where a plaintiff omits to sue in respect of or intentionally relinquish any portion of his claim, he shall not afterwards sue in respect of the portion so omitted. I'll tell you what. ये वाले एग्जाम्पल्स ये वाली जो इलस्ट्रेशंस हैं इनको अपने दिमाग में फिक्स कर लीजिए कि एग्ज़ाम में सोचने का टाइम नहीं है यही लिख कर आऊँगा. डू नॉट कुक अप फैंसी इलस्ट्रेशंस. सो द मोर एंड मोर बुक्स दैट यू रीड आई ऑल्सो हैव मल्टीपल बुक्स ऑन द CUPSC द मोर एंड मोर आई ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू राइट हाउएवर आई नीड टू मैनेज माई टाइम इन द एग्जाम. सो मोर एंड मोर फैंसियर इलस्ट्रेशंस विल डेफिनेटली एग्जिस्ट. द मोर यू विल ऑल्सो रीड द मोर यू विल ऑल्सो फाइंड कि नहीं ये वाली जौन सी भी इलस्ट्रेशन आपको पसंद आ रही है मुझे ये वाली इलस्ट्रेशन पसंद है. मैं मेंस में फिक्स कर लिया है कि यही लिखूंगा अगर मुझे इस टॉपिक पर आंसर लिखना हो. चीज़ें फिक्स करते चले जाइए इन जुडिशरी अदरवाइज इट विल नेवर एंड. दिस इज अ नेवर एंडिंग प्रोसेस इट इज इटर्नल इट इज इन्फिनिट. हाउ विल यू बिकॉज इवेंचुअली सी इवेंचुअली एट द एंड ऑफ द डे नोबडी केयर्स हाउ मच लॉ हाउ मच इन डेप्थ लॉ दैट यू स्टडीड एंड यू स्टडीड इट एंडलेसली. एंड में लोग जो एग्जाम के बाद पूछेंगे सीट आई कि नहीं आई. Even though that endless studying will help you in your practice, will help you in your LLM, maybe you want to become a teacher later on, whatever. Knowledge will not go to waste. But it certainly cannot ensure a seat because, see, Dronacharya aur Krishna mein farak hai. Mahabharat jeetne mein. Mahabharat Krishna jeeto jitwa sakte hai. Dronacharya nahi. To Dronacharya banenge to sare shastron ka PhD level ka gyan aa jayega. All CPC, VPC, all acts. However, that doesn't guarantee you clearing the exam. So we have to focus on clearing the exam. That is my main aim. All right. Illustration fix कर लीजिए और यहीं पर कहानी यहाँ पर दिमाग को भी यहाँ पर रख दिया अच्छा इसमें फिर ऐसे होगा फिर ऐसे होगा. ब्रेक लगाएं और आंसर राइटिंग पर फोकस करें. All right. Later she can't sue for the years 2000, the rent that was supposedly accruing to her in year 2000-2001. So this is, you are barred under Order 2, Rule 2. Another example, so try to give two illustrations per answer. If you give these mini illustrations, वहाँ पे वो मुकुल नंदनी जगह ए और बी ही करना, क्योंकि इनको ये जो हमारे जो भैया हैं जो चेक कर रहे हैं, इनको यही भाषा ए और बी वाली समझ में आती है, ए एंड बी एंड सी एंड डी, यही समझ में आती है. अगर हम फैंसी जाएंगे, नाम वाम लिखेंगे, जैसे कि मैं यहाँ लिख रहा हूँ, क्या पता पढ़े ही ना, इसको लगेगा पता नहीं यार ये कौन मुकुल कौन नंदिनी ले आया. ठीक है जी. ऑलराइट, सो ए एंड बी, एज एन ए ओज, ए हैज़ टू रिकवर फ्रॉम बी 2,20,000. So if A lets go of 20,000 to bring the suit within the jurisdiction, later on A is barred to sue for 20,000 in a fresh suit. This is what the object of Order 2, Rule 2 really is, right? So to take this plea, the defendant has to establish that. Write this down. So to take the plea of what? Of Order 2, Rule 2. Rule 2 ke andar sub rules hai. But Order 2, Rule 2 ki application lagi court mein ki sir, ये तो गलत था, ये तो पहले सूट में ही हो गया था, अब ये दोबारा आ गया है प्लेंटिफ. नाउ टू टेक दिस प्ली, द डिफेंडेंट हैज़ टू एस्टैब्लिश दैट दैट द प्रीवियस एंड द सेकंड सूट इज अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ द सेम कॉज ऑफ एक्शन. सो अ फ्रेश सूट विल नॉट, सो आउट ऑफ वन कॉज ऑफ एक्शन सीपीसी इज ट्राइंग टू लिमिट यू कि भाई एक ही बार आना एंड द होल ऑफ द क्लेम जो भी चाहते हो एक ही बार में बताओ. Previous and the second suit is arising out of the same cause of action. So to take the plea of order to rule 2, there has to be a second suit. Because how else are you going to take this plea? Because you are trying to object to the court. Ki, sir, ye ho chuka hai, ye aapne decision de chuke hain. Ye acha decision abhi chal bhi raha hai. Let us say dusra ek courtroom number 36 ya 35 ye sun raha hai. Ki, it is arising out of the same cause of action. How will you hear this? Court ke baas itna hi time pada that it will hear a plaintiff multiple times. No. डबल जेपडी में तो की फोकस वॉज कि कैन नॉट बी पनिश्ड. यहाँ पे द की फोकस इज कैन नॉट बी इवन ट्राइड. पनिशमेंट तो बहुत बाद में आएगी. ऑलराइट, वो तो फंडामेंटल राइट हो गया गिवन इन पार्ट 3 ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. कॉज ऑफ एक्शन इन सेकंड सूट हैड अरिजन एंड डिसाइडेड इन फर्स्ट एंड द अर्लियर सूट हैज बीन डिसाइडेड ऑन मेरिट्स. हाउ आर वी स्टैंडिंग ऑन द सेम इशूज अराइजिंग, और रादर नॉट सेम इशूज, इशूज अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ द सेम कॉज ऑफ एक्शन अगेन. बिकॉज अगर इतना ही करते रहेंगे तो हो जाएगा हमारा बेड़ा गर्क. राइट, सो ऑर्डर टू रूल टू के अंदर, इफ देर आर सेवरल रिलीफ्स इन द सेम कॉज ऑफ एक्शन, यू मस्ट सीक ऑल रिलीफ्स, अदरवाइज यू आर बार्ड एक्सेप्ट फॉर द लीव ऑफ कोर्ट विच इज साइन ए कुआ नॉन फॉर फ्रेश सूट. सो यहाँ पे भी कंडीशन है, आइदर यू सीक ऑल रिलीफ्स दैट आर अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ द सेम कॉज ऑफ एक्शन एट दैट वेरी मोमेंट इन योर फर्स्ट सूट ओनली, और इफ यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू डू दैट, then you tell the court ki I seek your leave to leave out these reliefs and I'll come back to it in a fresh suit if tomorrow it warrants that. Alright, so this is the sine qua non. Classic case law aap likh lijiye, Muhammad Khalil versus Mahroob Ali, AIR 1949, Privy Council ka case hai, PC 78. Of course citation yaad nahi rehne wali, but naam Muhammad Khalil versus Mahroob Ali ye likhna hi likhna hai. Order 2 Rule 2 pe case hai, is pe Privy Council ne आपकी कुछ गाइडलाइंस दी. सो क्लेम इन न्यू सूट इज इन फैक्ट फाउंडेड अपॉन अ न्यू कॉज ऑफ एक्शन डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम दैट ऑफ फर्स्ट. सो फर्स्टली वी आर गोइंग आफ्टर द कॉज ऑफ एक्शन, द कॉज ऑफ एक्शन शुड बी डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट सूट बिकॉज ऑर्डर टू रूल टू प्राइमरली रिलेट्स टू द सेकंड सूट. एविडेंस टू सपोर्ट क्लेम इज डिफरेंट, सो देयरफॉर कॉज ऑफ एक्शन इज गोइंग टू बी डिफरेंट. एंड थर्डली कॉज ऑफ एक्शन इज सेम इफ इन सब्सटेंस दे आर आइडेंटिकल. So technically speaking, mainly the test is revolving around whether the new suit is arising out of the same cause of action. If that is the case, the defendant's plea under Order 2, Rule 2 application लगाएगा कि सर ये देखिए, ये फिर से आप वही cause of action के बारे में आप बात सुन रहे हैं. सुनने नहीं देंगे आपको, CPC भी कह रही है कि जी नहीं सुनने देंगे. अच्छा, now we are at joined row parties, but उतना ही है. Now I'll come back to that order to rule to वाले पे res judicata के अंदर, जो कि most likely is going to be your next lecture after this. Joined row parties, A assaults B plus C simultaneously, and A assaults B and C on separate occasions. Let us say the days differ. On day one, A assaults B. Day two, A assaults C. A बड़ा बदमाश आदमी. And A assaults B plus C कि तेरी BCMC on one day only simultaneously. दिस इज द फर्स्ट वन इज सिंगल एक्ट और ट्रांजैक्शन, दूसरा वाले सेवरल एक्ट्स. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू. ऐसे एग्जामिनर को समझा कर आना. ए एंड बी बोथ असॉल्ट सी. क्वेश्चन इज कैन सी जॉइन ए एंड बी इन वन सूट और सेपरेट सूट्स आर रिक्वायर्ड ऑन ईच ऑफ दीज ओकेजन. वील जस्ट फिगर दिस आउट. सो ऑर्डर वन इज parties to suits, order 2 is frame of suit. order 1 parties to suit se kyon shuru ho raha hai bhaiya, pehle party to khojo suit ke liye. order 6 kya tha, order 7 kya tha, order 8 kya tha, order 21 kya tha, bar bar laga do. theek hai ji. okay, who may be joined as plaintiffs? all persons may be joined in one suit as plaintiffs where, okay, all persons. can there be multiple plaintiffs? yes, there can be. order 1 yahi se shuru ho raha hai. any right to relief in respect of arising out of the same act or transaction, use this word in your answer. all right, so same act or transaction or series of acts or transactions is alleged to exist in such persons, whether jointly, severally or in the alternative. and so there are two conditions attached to it. If such persons brought separate suits, any common question of law or fact would arise. Let us say that all of them want to sue separately. It is pretty much the same transaction, same common questions of law or fact arise. We can join the plaintiffs. We can join the defendants as well. Pause the lecture here. Just read the rule. It is word to word. Yehi wala, there is pretty much no difference to it. Okay? Power of court to order separate trial. Let us say join one to ho gaye sare ke sare ikatte mil gaye. where it appears to the court any joinder or plaintiff may embarrass or delay the trial of the suit. pre ka question dikhai diya. any time court ke upar jo bhi condition aa rahi hai ki is condition ke andar court kuch aur kar sakta hai, that is a question. I'm giving you the pattern of the question paper. The court may put the plaintiffs to the election or order separate trials. So can the court order separate trials? Order 1, rule 2, can there, it is crystal clear that yes, it can. Or make such other order as may be expedient. Great. All right. So who may be joined as defendants? Again, it is pretty much same act or transaction hui hai. In cases ke andar, like A assaults B plus C simultaneously, can they both be joined as plaintiffs? Sure. A assaults B on one day, C on one day, can they file separate suits? Sure. But can they be joined as plaintiffs also? Agar A ne bilkul similar maar pitai kari hai? Yeah, sure. Common question of law of fact. yehi maar pitai kar raha hai. Aajo, sare ke sare aajo, club out kar lete. Why so? What is the object? To save the court's time. Alright, so this is joinder of parties. So technically speaking, all your orders in the first schedule are starting with joinder of parties. So the two conditions you'll have to, same act or transaction, and if common questions, as in common question of law or fact, jo aa rahe hain, agar wo hain, you can join the as plaintiffs. Similarly, you can just join as defendants. The keyword is same act or transaction, and that is the MCQ in pre from order 1. Rule 1. So now example, A and B buy debentures in a company, and based on the prospectus that they read of the company, debentures as in stock shares in the company. Now tomorrow the directors turned out to be fraudulent. They want to bring damages, they want to claim damages against directors. A and B may join because transaction technically speaking is the same. You're reading the prospectus, you're getting fooled and you're buying the shares, and now you want damages. A and B may join. The transaction is mainly the same. Order 1, Rule 1 and 3, the object is to avoid multiplicity of suits and unnecessary expenses to litigants. You want to keep the cost of justice as low as possible so that it is accessible to as many as possible. A rides cab of B. It collides with C's car. A may join B and C as defendants in one suit. Because it was the same transaction, common question, pata nahi ek kaun se kisi taxi mein baith gaya, cab of B ke andar, and it collides with C's car. maan lete hain ki C bhi galti mein tha wahan par. A keh raha hai tum dono se paise leke maangunga. civil suit hai na, after at the end jail bail to bhejna nahi mujhe tumhe, dono se mujhe damages hai. so A may join B and C as defendants in one suit because it's the same transaction, common question. all right. Now A gets assaulted by B and B's son. Can A file one suit against both of them? Yeah, sure, because, well, the test is same transaction. You can join one suit as a defendant, B, ये आपके B और B's son को बना दो, ठीक है जी, अच्छा जी. Now let us say that A, B and C, well, they get into separate contracts with varying terms with D at D's factory to supply coal. And all of them somehow fail. कोई COVID lockdown लग गया और ऐसा मतलब कुछ failure हो गया. Three contracts थी. There were three separate transactions because the keyword that I've told you is the terms were different of these contracts. D, they cannot join. So D cannot sue them in one go. D will have to sue them in different because the contracts were different. So is the transaction same? No. All right. So ये तो हो गया joinder of parties. जैसे कि हमने पहली डिस्टिंक्शन ले ली नेसेसरी पार्टी प्रॉपर पार्टी एक्सेट्रा. अब द कीवर्ड इज सॉरी मिस्टेक हो गया है. व्हाट डू मीन बाय दैट? मिसजॉइंडर ऑफ पार्टीज. मिसजॉइंडर गलत कर दिया है आपने. कैन द कोर्ट स्प्लिट देम आउट? रिमेंबर द प्रोसीजरल लॉ इज इट ऑलवेज एड्स द सब्सटेंटिव लॉ. इट इज टेक्निकली स्पीकिंग वी कांट से इट इज अ मियर टेक्निकलिटी. But it plays the role of technicality only. It cannot hamper the administration of justice at the end of the day, right? So objections as to non-joinder or misjoinder. All objections on the ground of non-joinder or misjoinder of parties shall be taken at the earliest possible opportunity in all cases where issues are settled or at before such settlement unless the ground of objection has subsequently arisen and any such objection not taken shall be deemed to have been waived. Kahin pe humne pehle padha hua pichle lectures mein? Of course padha hua hai. Check whether I am in order 1 or I am in order 2. Roam around your barrack and check. Kahan par hoon main? Theek hai ji. Acha. Or whether I am in a section. Find this. Misjoinder and non-joinder. Section 9. No suit shall be defeated by reason of misjoinder or non-joinder of parties. And the court may in every suit deal with the matter in controversy. So far as regards the rights and interests of parties actually before it. Check whether this is a rule or whether I am in a section. Open your bare act to this. I will not now repeat because we have covered it. I am intentionally doing this. Taki aapko yaad reh jaye ki ye kahan pe de rakha misjoinder and non-joinder. Alright. However, yaad hai proviso jo ki humne pehle bhi itni bari ye raha proviso. Thoda color change kar lete so that you can read this. Provided that nothing in this rule shall apply to the non-joinder of a necessary party. You remember in the previous lectures we already done this. If you can't remember, then well, you'll have to revise. Right. No suit shall be defeated by the reason of misjoinder or non-joinder of parties. So suit, it is misjoinder or non-joinder of parties is not fatal. However, if there is a misjoinder or non-joinder of a necessary party, the suit can fail. It can prove fatal to the suit. And the court may in every suit deal with the matter in controversy so far as regards the rights of interest of the parties actually before it. So this is not fatal to the suit. However, this is only a remedial defect. It can be cured except in the case of a necessary party. Open your bare act. Find out where this is since we have already done this. Now, order 1, rule 10. Subrule 2. Open your bare act and see the court has the power also to strike out a party. Kya rahe galti se isko kya bana rakha tumne party suit mein? Then bhejo isko. So all of these applications will be taken by mostly is in this case the defendant he plea dalega ki dekho ji please strike out my name. I am not, you know, I don't have any interest in this suit. I don't have any liability, etc. Why? What am I doing here? Right. Achha, section 99. Jo ki humne pehle kara tha. No decree shall be reversed or substantially varied up. कह रहा है पहले तो जो बात हो रही थी यहाँ पे how does this different? No suit shall be defeated. वो कहता है suit would सब खत्म. अब decree भी आ गई लेकिन no decree shall be reversed or substantially varied. Nor shall any case be remanded in appeal on account of any misjoinder or non-joinder of parties or causes of action of any error, defect or irregularity in any proceeding of the suit, not affecting the merits of the case or the jurisdiction of the court, all right, provided that nothing in this section shall apply to non-joinder of necessary party. Again and again and again the words repeat. Hopefully this is clear. I won't discuss this any further because section 99 mein we've already discussed it. Acha. No decree shall be reversed. Matlab, judgment decree aa gayi, suit has ended, the trial has ended. Wo keh raha hai ab uske baad misjoinder non-joinder ke chakkar mein I won't, I'm not going to be hearing this. ठीक है जी, okay. ये तो हो गई parties की बात. However, can you join causes of action? Yeah, sure. Joinder of causes of action, save as otherwise provided. A plaintiff may unite in the same suit several causes of action against the same defendant. Or the same defendants jointly, and any plaintiff having cause of action in which they are jointly interested against the same defendant or the same defendants jointly may unite such cause of action in the same suit, right? Achha. Then we go to rule 4, only certain claims to be joined for the recovery of immovable property. So order to rule 4, only certain claims to be joined for recovery of immovable property, no cause of action shall, unless with the leave of the court, see, be joined with a suit for the recovery of an immovable property, claims for mean profits, so this is how you pronounce it, it's mean profits, or arrears of rent in respect of the property claimed or any part thereof. So, no cause of action shall, unless with the leave of court, be joined with a suit for the recovery of immovable property, except, so, ye yahan pe leave of the court nahi required. Claim of damages for breach of any contract under which the property or any part thereof, claims in which the relief is sought based on the same cause of action. I'll come back to this when we go for TPA. TPA ke saath hi immovable property ka hi sara kaam kar rahe hain, right? But ek bari bas upar upar se pad lijiye isko. Power of court to order separate trials. Remember, this is now, you know, order to rule 6 is a power of the court. That is pretty much your power. You will need to know this. Where it appears to the court that joinder of any cause of action in one suit may embarrass or delay the trial or is otherwise inconvenient, the court may order separate trials or make such other order as may be expedient in the interests of justice. Let us say a plaintiff has joined several causes of action and is coming in with the same trial. Court keh raha hai, this is becoming too complicated, I can't do this. Like, for example, you'll be saying this. You can order separate trials. Okay. Objections as to misjoinder. All objections on the ground of misjoinder of cause of action shall be taken at the, again, it almost always is at the earliest possible opportunity in all cases where issues are settled or at before such settlement, unless the ground of objection has subsequently arisen and any such objection is not so taken shall be deemed to have been waived. Satark rahe, savdhan rahe, objection jo bhi hai. Because see, eventually what are you objecting against? You are objecting against the court's power ki aap ye kaam kaise kar rahe hain. The CBC is limiting your power. That is what you are telling the court ki bhai ye kya ho raha hai. Multiple cause of actions pe aap baatein kar rahe hain. Plaintiff alag galat laga diya hai apne. Defendant kisi ko alag join kara diya hai. You take these objections at the earliest possible opportunity. Ye nahi ki puri matlab puri ramayan khatam ho gaya aur end mein aap keh rahe nahi ho dekho wo shuru mein na wo galat kiya tha Vanvas ne. But you should have objected back then. Ab to Ravan Sita ko utha ke le gaya aur Sri Ram wapas bhi utha ke le aaye. राइट, सीता जी को रिकवरी कर गए हैं, अब किस बात की ऑब्जेक्शन? ठीक है जी, ओके. दिस ऑलमोस्ट ऑलवेज पॉप्स अप इन प्री. ओके, सो ऑर्डर 1 रूल 10 इज द कोर्ट मे एट एनी स्टेज ऑफ प्रोसीडिंग्स. एमसीक्यू देखो, एट व्हाट स्टेज? एनी स्टेज, आइदर अपॉन और विदाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ आइदर पार्टी. तो कोर्ट की बहुत ब्रॉड पावर देती है. वेरी सिमिलर टू 319 ऑफ द ओल्ड CRPC, बट वहाँ पे क्या होता था, एक्यूज पकड़ लेते थे. अब यहाँ पे एक्यूज तो नहीं पकड़ेंगे. एंड ऑन सच टर्म्स एज मे अपीयर टू द कोर्ट टू बी जस्ट, ऑर्डर दैट द नेम ऑफ एनी पार्टी इम्प्रॉपरली जॉइंड, वेदर एज प्लेंटिव और डिफेंडेंट, बी स्ट्रक आउट, एंड दैट द नेम ऑफ एनी पर्सन हु ऑट टू हैव बीन जॉइंड, वेदर एज प्लेंटिव और डिफेंडेंट, और हुज प्रेजेंस बिफोर द कोर्ट मे बी नेसेसरी इन ऑर्डर टू इनेबल द कोर्ट टू इफेक्चुअली एंड कंप्लीटली टू एडजुडिकेट अपॉन एंड सेटल ऑल द क्वेश्चन इन्वॉल्विंग द सूट, बी added pure order ke andar, perhaps the most important rule and sub rule. Order 1 rule 10 sub rule 2 most important. Can the code do it on its own without any application? Yeah, sure. Whether ye aapka yahan pe likha hua hai, upon or without the application of either party also, the code can bring you in the dock or the code can send you home ki tum jao, tumhare yahan se koi lena dena nahi. Therefore, this is one of your very wide powers, your as in master of the courtroom ki very very wide powers. Kripya karke ye dimag mein rakhiye. Alright. Where defendant added plaint to be amended, this is also a pre-ka question standard. Where a defendant is added, the plaint shall, unless the court otherwise directs, be amended in such manners as may be necessary. Amendment, where is it given? Kaun sa rule 17 tha? Kaun sa order tha? Check karo, bear act mein dhoondo. Kar chuke hum ye wala sara kaam. Baar baar, dobara dobara nahi karenge. Okay. Next, related topic, we go to res judicata, then we go to steps in a suit, and then, because now we are pretty much in deep waters of the CPC, and then फिर आगे काम कर लेंगे. It is as simple as that. I see you in the next lecture. However, try to sit with one mains का question daily. If you're preparing for the DGS, one mains का question daily you sit. If you're preparing for the other states, जो जिस भी format में आपके state के जो question आ रहे हैं relating to these topics, try to write them. आप कहेंगे मैं दोबारा lecture देखूँ, कुछ है नहीं होना उस. कुछ भी नहीं होना. या तो आपने लेक्चर ढंग से पहले सुना नहीं, बार बार लेक्चर देखे, वो लोग कहते हैं पांच बार देख लेंगे, क्या होगा उस. वहाँ लेक्चर देखने का कॉम्पिटिशन है, आंसर राइटिंग का कॉम्पिटिशन है. आंसर राइटिंग का कॉम्पिटिशन, टू राइट द डैम आंसर्स, प्रैक्टिस इट. ऑलराइट, वील अगेन बिफोर द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर अगेन सारे सेक्शन रिवाइज करेंगे, सारे ऑर्डर रिवाइज करेंगे, और फिर अब रेस जुडिकाटा का काम कर लेते हैं, बिकॉज नाउ वी आर रेडी फाइनली टू एंटर इन टू द वाटर्स ऑफ रेस जुडिकाटा एंड रेस सब जुडिस. And then we'll basically proceed ahead to steps in the suit, etc. Res judicata, ugly lecture. Take care, bye.